students, good morning and welcome to our English literature class. In today's class, we shall take up the lesson A Piece of Peace, taken from your literature book, Unit 1, Section B. Students, the name of the lesson is A Piece of Peace. First piece, P-I-E-C-E, means a small part of something, a big unit. It can be a broken part of something which is big. And second piece, P-S-C-E, means harmony, tranquility, lack of violence, etc. Now, what are we talking about? What is that piece which is full of peace and tranquility? We are talking about that particular land of the earth where there is only peace and tranquility, no violence, there is joy, there is harmony, there is no any inhuman activities. And today we shall take up such piece of land that is called Antarctica, the white continent which is found in the southern part of earth. So this is the piece, that is the small part of land which is full of peace, full of tranquility, harmony. Students, how do we know such a great detail about this far off land? Definitely we have many sources. First of all, from the geographical history, we know that over 200 million years ago, there existed one supercontinent that was called Gondwana land. Now, this Gondwana land comprised of what today we had the continents and countries like Australia, Africa, South America, India, New Zealand, and today's Antarctica. This Gondwana land eventually underwent a geographical movement, geographical phenomenon called continental drift. Through this phenomenon, there took place a split of this Gondwana land into two, and one smaller piece emerged from this Gondwana land that was called Australian continent. And this Australian continent continued for several million years, and that contained what we have today, Australia and Antarctica. Now, this Australia and Antarctica, today we have separate, they remain together in Australian continent. And about 40 million years from today, 40 million years ago, this Australian continent also went through the continental drift and again split into two, and what today we have Australia and Antarctica. And today we have the Antarctica continent remaining in the southernmost part of the earth. Now let us continue understanding, finding out what we know about continent of Antarctica. So we come to know through explorers what is going on in Antarctica, what is present in Antarctica, what are the phenomena that happen in Antarctica, what are the creatures live there. So many things we come through explorers. In the process of explorers going to Antarctica, firstly we had Captain Cook, who landed there in 1773. He made a circumference around Antarctica and found out so many strange phenomena. Then followed by another explorer, Professor Green, accompanied by his team. We shall see this slide again. So these explorers found out some unique findings. First of all, they found out that there is no human settlement, no homes, no towns, no cities, no factories, nothing. Then they found out there is complete tranquility, complete peace, only some sound of the water, sea water on the shores. Then they found out it was beautiful, it has beautiful appearance. Then they found out that there is a large number of sea creatures, plenty of sea creatures, not that it is covered with ice and there is no any creature. There are plenty of sea creatures there, small, big, that we shall see ahead. Then they found out that there is constant change of temperature, fluctuation of temperature, and they found out that that change of temperature is very harmful for Antarctica and every component of Antarctica. Then they found out that the seas are in the frozen state, frozen hard. They found that the fogs are very thick, so thick fogs are found there. Snowstorms are common there. Intense cold, no warmth of the sun. They can see the sun, but no warmth is felt. Then let us see Professor Green, accompanied by 4 teachers and 16 students. They had gone there with the aim of specific study. So they discovered and found out some unique result. So let us see what they found out. First of all, they found out that the sea creatures called seals, then are in innumerous number, great number, and people go there to hunt the seals. Of course, this is very inhuman, cruel action of man, but people go there to hunt seals, and they found out that often the seal hunters are bitten on their fingers, and they discovered that those fingers get septic, poison, and those fingers become inactive, completely immobile. And ironically, those fingers are called sealer's fingers. Then they found out that the entire Antarctica appears glistening, shining. And they found out that there is no wildlife existing there. Then they found out something very unique in the month of September, because they happened to visit there in the month of September, and they found out that in the month of September there is 24-hour daylight, there is no sunset. That was their unique discovery. Then they found out that the climate change is very rapid. No one can predict when and how much there is change of temperature. They found out that even up to 13 degrees Celsius the temperature can rise. And they found out that rise of temperature is very, very harmful for Antarctica and every component there, even for the visitors. Then many scientists frequently visit there, large number of scientists go there, and these scientists have come out with great findings. They have come out with the finding that there is a large number of living creatures, even they say equal or even more than what the living creatures are there in any other fresh water, in the river, in the sea, in the lake. So the water creatures are in large number there. And then continued their discovery, and to discover that
Antarctica, only 0.4% is not covered with ice. Otherwise, nearly the entire Antarctica is covered with ice. Then they found out that in winter, the size, the area of Antarctica doubles up to 20 million square kilometer. Now, 20 million square kilometer means almost equal to 1.5 of the size of USA, 2 Australia continent, and even 50 UK, that much of the area is enlarged in winter. Now, they continued their discovery and found out that when there is the temperature rise, warmth increases, there is plenty of ice water, ice, and there is a great many impact. First of all, there is erosion taking place. Then this erosion is dangerous for polar bears, seals, and many other sea creatures. And they found out that when there is the temperature rise, then there is increase of winter precipitation in the southern part of the western countries, the southeastern part of even America, USA. Then they found out that the global warming, which we know is very, very harmful, the global warming has a great impact on Antarctica. They found out that nearly 5 times more impact is there in Antarctica than any other part of the Earth. They found out that in the last 50 years, there is increase of temperature by 2.5 degrees centigrade, and this has very, very harmful effect on the Earth. And as a result of temperature rise, there is melting of the ice water. Melting of the ice water means rise of the sea water level. Rise of the sea water level means there can be submergence of many cities of the world which are situated on the seashore. And it is what the danger is being felt today. Then, lastly, they found out that the amount of ice water is nearly 1,000 times more than what is in the North Pole. So students, this is what the account of Antarctica appears of this. I hope you got a good amount of information and extensive information about Antarctica. For today, that's all. Keep learning, keep safe. Thank you.